Hey guys, welcome back to SeatStory Cup. Hold on 1 second. Yep. All right,
that's
there we
the
go.
One.
Yep. Number three, actually, not number one. Number one was a long time ago, Crip. But yeah, here we are, and it's day number two. We're going through that round of 32 right now, getting those first two groups done. We do have a winner match coming up. Savitz, what do you think?
It's going to be a great match. Ignite going up against Amaz. We saw some really long game there. Might be some more long games. It might be some short games. I don't remember Ignite's lineup exactly.
I think the really interesting part here is actually the losers match. I remember when we first kicked off the tournament, we were talking about like which players we think might move on and get to the final. My two players were Gera and Theiss.
Yeah, and here they are, and only one of them can even have a chance.
No, that's pretty bad predictions right there.
Well, yeah.
Well, one of them still has a chance.
Yeah. And that it's kind of like breaking my heart because Theiss got kind of slain. I always like think that he's going to win stuff, but I loved Gaara's decks in that last match.
Oh yeah,
they were so cool. The fact that he's playing like a weird ramp druid with Doomsayers, are you kidding me? It's so cool.
Something like just died inside me when I saw the double Doomsayers and he lost to the Mech Mage, because that's what you want to have against Mech Mage. Specifically decked against Mech Mage, because when they have the mirror entity up, you drop a Doomsayer and that's like such a blowout. But he just got so unlucky there.
Well. We have seen a lot of top deck fireballs in this tournament so far.
Yep. Turns out it's a pretty good card to have two of when your opponent has 13 life.
Oh, yeah.
When you generally speaking, especially when you have 10 mana.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That hero power, man. Mm-hmm. Who needs a hunter hero power when you can aim it at anything?
Wow.
Don't need any Storm Weedle or whatever that thing is.
Steam Weedle Sniper.
Yeah, Steam Weedle Sniper. Before we get too much into the game, I actually want to show my monitor for a second here and talk about the donation stuff. So... this is the page that you guys should be on. And
TakeTV.net.
Yeah, TakeTV.net. And this is where you should be watching. See, we see all these awesome faces. You guys are really clever to put all these faces in this chat like this.
Wow.
Wow. And if you scroll down here, you can hit this donation button. And here you have it. Half of all the donations go straight into the prize pool. Mm-hmm. So this is going to be money in Savit's pocket. He's really excited about it. Please go ahead and donate as much as you'd like. But we have another thing that we're going to do here once we reach the $230 prize pool. So we're a little bit off that right now.
Can't wait to see what it is. I have like no idea.
It's I don't know if I'm supposed to say what it is. So
I thought we were supposed to say what
it is. I am supposed to say what it
you
is.
Are?
It's going to have something to do with Raynad and a piñata.
Oh, man. I was gonna hype it up better than that.
I don't think you can possibly hype it better than that. Oh, Raynad versus piñata?
Okay. Yeah, we should have... entered like a boxing match. And in one corner, we had, you know,
the owner
of Tempo Storm.
The man started it all.
In the other, we have
a piñata.
Yeah.
So who would you think?
I just want to see what the excuses would be if the piñata won. That's what I would say.
Well, when you hit it and it explodes, sometimes you're caught in that shrapnel, you know?
There's a lot of RNG like where the shrapnel lands.
Yeah. Yeah. You never know. I mean, it's basically Hearthstone all over again.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Let's read actually a couple of these donation things. I want to, because this is a way that people get a lot of donations, right? Is they read all the stuff that comes up on the donations.
Yeah, so that's generally how they.
Let's jump over there.
Yeah, I spotted one there right away. Forsenpois torilla tavata vittu saatana. It's amazing. It's really cool to see that people are like sending some of these messages in Finnish.
Where is it?
Two down. There we go. Okay, so that's actually like a.
Oh, meet me in the town square.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I speak Finnish.
There's also some like naughty words in the end, but
Forsen boys, that is a naughty word.
Yeah, that's a naughty word for some sure. But so there's only one Finnish player here, but apparently back at home there's more than one watching, so that's cool.
Yeah.
Are you the only Finnish player?
Yeah, I am. There's like seven Swedish people and only one Finnish. I don't know what's that all about. Like that's not cool. Finnish people need to like step up and
well, you know what you gotta do to those Swedes. You gotta finish them.
Oh, definitely one by one.
That was
awesome.
Okay,
that was epic. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about the match a little bit. Right, we have from Amaz. Well, actually, both of them are bringing Druid and Mage, and then Amaz has Warlock Warrior, and Ignite has Paladin Priest. Mm-hmm. So, what do you see as the main differences there, Savitz? Also, if someone in production could turn up my headset, that would be great. This is, like, so soft.
Warrior, Paladin, Priest.
Trying to spot if there's, like, one deck that can't win any games. Well, personally, like, I really dislike priests. This is just my thing, but yeah. I don't like the priests that people have been bringing here at all. Like, the type of priests that we've seen have been, like, the not the ones with double light bomb, which is, in my opinion, it's the better way to play priests right now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say that Amaz is going to take this just because Ignite can't win any games with the priest.
Okay.
Do we know what type of Warlock Amaz is playing?
We don't. It got banned last time.
Okay. So if it is like a controlling Warlock, I actually don't think Ignite has too great of a matchup with anything.
Yeah, I would imagine he's going to ban Warlock here. In fact, I believe he had banned Warlock in the first one. Yeah, he did. So he's going to ban Warlock.
Okay.
So we're not even going to know what Amaz is playing.
Okay. Well, that's really the big concern there. I just look at the decks, and because each of them has to win something.
Yeah.
That's how this format works. I don't think Ignite has a great matchup against Warlock with anything.
Yeah, that's... Well, Paladin generally does all right, but I believe that Amaz banned Paladin in his previous match from Thais.
Yes, he did.
From Gaara, sorry. Mm-hmm. So I would expect to see the Paladin ban again here, because it's like something that he doesn't want to play against.
Wouldn't be surprised about that at all. So,
yeah, and I mean after that, his lineup should be kind of all right against everything that the Ignite is bringing.
Yeah,
I would actually be really surprised if he banned anything else.
I'm kind of curious because Amaz has that control warrior with, you know, all the right number of big minions. Mm-hmm. How that would actually play into the Priest of the Death Lords.
Yeah, that can go wrong sometimes. Yeah.
Well, as a priest, you can't even really play the Death Lords on like turn 3 or anything because of the executes and stuff.
Well, you gotta wait for them. To play all your cards throughout, or you can't actually win. Especially knowing that his is like a buff priest.
Yeah, but the way to do it is if you're on Death Lords, you usually have light bombs for catching up like on the board. Mm. So you wait for the turns where you can light bomb on the following turn as the Death Lord is killed. So when the Death Lord dies and they already have minions on board, they will have more stuff, and then it's just like. Yeah. Wipe away everything on one time.
Well, the priest, the mage, stay in it. Priest opens up.
All right.
Am I supposed to be observing... Oh, Sixa?
No.
Sixa's account.
Ignite.
Oh, Ignite. Okay. There we go. All right. Got it going.
Or maybe we have it backwards. Well, someone will yell at us, so we'll know soon.
Nobody's ever going to yell at us. Don't worry. You asked for it. Okay, so it looks like, Warlock banned and Pally banned as
I think
as
we
expected.
Do have it backwards, though.
Do we?
Yeah, and I think you're doing some Windows updates.
I think this is a great time for Windows updates.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yep.
As always.
When is it not, you know? You got to update your system.
Well, for now, we just sit down, Mage and which it doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, Mage for... Mage versus Priest, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. That's right.
I think.
And actually, this would be the good matchup then for Ignite, right? If he's Death Lords.
This is like the shoe-in if you get a decent hand.
I think we saw a Death Lord, but he was like running also like Blade Masters. And there was like Holy Fire.
If you stick one creature, it usually gets buffed past the point where the Mage can never kill it.
Yeah. That's true. Like if he gets the Blade Master running early, because if he, like, let's say, he plays it with a circle, it can be a really strong turn.
Now I don't know for sure what type of priest it is, but I have seen Deathlord priests running Divine Spirits and stuff with all the buffs.
Oh, okay.
And it's basically the hard counter to Mage, because you have like a 30 HP Deathlord.
Yeah.
And when it dies, you get a minion. Yeah. When it dies, right?
Good luck.
Yeah. So if that is what's going on, it should be quite devastating.
Yeah, we'll see. Like, Mech Mage is one of those decks that can sometimes have a really tough time recovering if a complete board clear happens on, like, let's say, turn 4 or 5. Mm-hmm. So is this... Oh, wow. Okay.
Well that's...
So a pretty good start.
Yeah, I would say so. Didn't even need the... What's he... Gelblin? That thing you were using in your pre-stack?
Oh, yeah, the stealth one. Yeah.
Gilblin.
Gilblin. You could just...
I think it's pronounced Gilblin.
Gilblin?
I think it's Gilblin.
It's got two L's in it.
Is it Gilblin?
I'm pretty sure it's Gilblin. Yeah.
Gilblin Stalker.
Gilbling. Okay.
All right.
I might have been like really wrong about this priest thing though when I was said that it can't beat anything because it's like it's looking like it's gonna beat the.
I think this like the best matchup for this priest deck is Mech Mage.
So Ignite
out of all the decks.
Yeah, that might have been his plan for this all along.
Yeah, it seems like Ignite got the mind games right for game one. Let's see if he has a circle of healing here. That would be so.
This is over. Naru, this is completely over.
Yeah, even Light of Naru is really strong.
But yeah, a circle of healing here would just be a win.
Mm-hmm. He's not doing.
We're gonna try to get this other computer fixed so we can see that.
But he's not doing it straight away. That means he either doesn't have it or he has.
Or he does have it.
I think he just wants to attack next turn with both. I think that's the idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
he'll win that race.
Yeah. It really suck to be Amaz right now.
I would say so.
Like, how are you supposed to clear two minions with 7 health? And if you ignore them, they're just going to keep killing your stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess Antonidas Cloakfield is like something that can always win games. But just like trying to control the board, winning it seems almost impossible at this point.
The worst part is when this happens in Arena.
Really?
And it does, yeah.
It does, yeah.
The Northshire going second into Coin Velens.
Wow.
You just don't know what to do. Because you're not playing combo, you're not playing much draw.
Yeah.
And then you're like, well, he's 6 cards ahead with a creature I can't kill that's going to draw him more cards.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
You've sold me on it. If I ever play Arena again, I'll definitely choose Priest.
But the Flame Strikes, though. Well, it's pretty easy, 12 wins.
Well, Flame Strike doesn't do 7. As we see, this board is very 7-y.
It's really, really 7-y.
Well, you know, this is kind of funny. Like, Ignite actually went through the qualifier, right?
Yeah.
He didn't get a straight invite.
I didn't know that.
I'm pretty sure he was one of the qualifier winners.
I think so, though.
Yeah. So, like, not only is he going through the qualifiers, he, like, slained his first opponent, Tice, who's, like, one of the big picks to win. Now he's against Amaz, game one, dominating so far. Maybe he just chose the best decks.
Maybe. Yeah, that's interesting. The event phase there. Is that Dust kind of?
I think I like the.
I would have probably killed off this Snow Chaga there. I don't know.
I like the sheep into the Northshire into Tinkertown.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
I guess it's Lotheb.
Okay, sure. Works too. I mean, it does contest the board for now. Like, the Blade Master alone can't kill it. And because of the Lotheb effect, you can't really buff it right now. You could smite and trade him, but that's pretty bad.
No, I think with the Miranti up, we're just going to see some garbage creature being played from the Priest. And that's going to be the easy prey.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to try to get this computer fixed. I'll let you guys talk for a minute.
Yep. Can you just shake it up a little bit?
Usually does the trick.
Yeah.
If it doesn't, then you just shake it up a little bit more. All right, deals with the mirror entity. Not the best way to do it, but it does get the job done. And nothing is at 1 HP for him right now, so it's not like the Mage Hero power could kill a minion by itself.
All right.
That's potentially a really good turn for him here. It does leave him kind of open to some kind of combo, but you shouldn't be too scared of the Orcanite Circle, because you just saw one Orcanite. So look at those minions there with like the green borders around them. Just play them all. Like, you have a late game.
Yeah.
You get a spare part. You actually get 2 spare parts for the upcoming Antonidas.
You get the one immediately.
One immediately.
You might not get that last one. It might be Shadow Madness or Cabal.
Yeah, that's true. But one guaranteed. And one is all you need if it's a Cloakfield. So then with a Cloakfield or something other awesome things, he would just have like a Dr. Boom for next turn. And then let's see if it is. It would be absolutely huge if he got the Cloakfield here.
Yeah, it would.
Yep.
Aww.
Yeah, plus 1 armor.
I guess it could have been for worse, but no, not really. What would have been worse? Not even sure.
No. If that was Geddon from Blackrock, he should have not played the Mech Warper first, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Geddon turned out to be really easy.
Huh?
Turned out to be really easy.
Well, you're just a genius, Crypt.
Yeah. Pandas. I told you. It's all about the pandas.
Yep. Abusing that Blackrock AI.
It's not hard.
Well, I mean, this is actually... If this clockwork gives him, as you were saying, Savitz, you know, the finicky cloaking field, that's pretty sick. Because next turn he gets to Dr. Boom. He's getting a really ridiculously strong board.
Yeah. But that's like his only chance at this point, I think. We can't see Ignite's hand right now, but he has 9 cards, so we can just imagine that everything possible is in there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there has to be a good turn. Ignite is not taking his time here because he doesn't have a play. It's just like he's trying to figure out, like, yeah, okay. Yeah, that's pretty good. Can't be bad.
Clears just right. about everything.
Yeah.
Yep. We can trade that one up too. Which spare body? Oh.
It's still two spare parts. It's still two fireballs. I think when you're running like that many buffs, it's hard to run enough creatures for the buffs and the extra heals.
Yeah, that's true.
So I think there's some pretty decent chance you have to have like Holy Fire. Mm-hmm. And with enough fireballs, without Holy Fire, you're not going to win.
Yeah, the Holy Fire is also like kind of clunky in a way.
Yeah.
Like a lot of priest players have chosen to cut it because it's like, it costs so much mana, and in some matchup the healing is not even like relevant, so...
Yeah.
It's kind of... Well, some people run one, but I mean, one is the absolute maximum, and even the one can be sometimes really difficult to use.
All right, I'm back.
Good to have you back.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, four face.
They're trying to fix the computer.
Yeah, it's basically a bonus fireball.
Mm-hmm. Not bad. More than a dark pump.
Oh! Three face.
Nice.
No problem.
That's the cleric. Doesn't really do much, but I guess might as well get it out there.
Yeah. Are you saving the Antonitis to play both the spare parts, I guess?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, so maybe the Sky Golem here?
Yeah, it looks like the only play, I think. I mean, you don't want a spider tank, because you can't play both, so you gotta just play one, so yeah. It has to be the Golem. Probably like even Bing Phase. Just hope to like, draw one fireball naturally and get two extra from the Antonitis.
Antonitis is a funny card, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure
is. It lets you win quite a few games that you should not win.
Yeah, it's interesting because yeah. it's like plan B for the mech mage in a way. Like the plan A is to just swarm the board and like play all your cheap minions early on and finish with the Fireball Frostbolt. But the Antonitis can sometimes, even when you're in really bad shape, it can give you an extra out.
Oh, this is going to matter a lot if something good comes out of here.
Whoa! What?
I think that's pretty good. I mean, it can get death, but there's only one death remaining, right?
Oh my god.
He did cast one death. So yeah.
You know what? Like this actually could become... This is pretty sick, actually. I really like this.
Yeah, it's a good one to get for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, he can't get trade for it. He probably has to. He has to hero power it first and then trade in.
You know, I couldn't remember what this was called. I was looking for it this morning.
Oh,
I was trying to make something.
Ember Ambusher.
Yeah, no, I typed in Nerubian and it didn't come up and I was like, alright, whatever.
The Nerubian, Web Lord.
Because I wanted to use this guy against... Baron Geddon in the thing. I was like, oh, this guy could be cool. I could bounce my own stuff with him.
So do pandas.
Yeah, but this guy's like a spider panda.
Spider panda. Wow.
Yeah.
Blizzard should hire you. I mean, there's going to be more expansions, and I don't think they came up with that.
Lothep delays the Antonitis a turn.
Yep, sure does. Well, this is one of those turns where you're kind of worried about playing a Snow Chaka because it's kind of likely that there's a Cabal right now.
Yeah.
But I mean, what else do you just keep it in your hand? It doesn't really do all that much there either. I guess it kind of enables if you draw like another Tinkertown or something. It's kind of nice to have a mech.
Well, aren't you here just relying completely on Antonitis at this point?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
So I feel like I would just play it and keep pinging face and just be like, all right. I mean, this is my one out is what I have in my hand at the moment.
Mm-hmm. If he has a Cabal in his hand, I think this is gonna be a really quick turn. Taking out the spider thing and stealing that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, here it comes.
Let me change your mind.
Do you heal Lothep here?
I don't know, I would probably... do you heal it? That's actually a good question. Because you're at 17, and if there's like a Holy Fire in hand, you might feel...
Well, it's that if there's a small creature that you need to kill, you use the 4-5 anyway.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so...
Well, that's pretty
how
good.
How much can he deal here? So if he like, goes Antonitis, Frostbolt Phase, gets a spare, but he puts the priest down to 14. Well, that's not really good enough. Like, even with the last Frostbolt top deck and two fireballs in his hand, he would be one off. But you can't really be clearing here either. And can you just, like, hero power pass? That seems so bad.
Could do it one time.
Well, you have to think about it this way.
What are you looking for to even draw?
No, the thing is, like, where is Antonitis ever going to be better than this? It's when you get a third spare part. How likely is it you're going to get a third spare part anytime soon?
No, you're not going to get a third spare part.
So I think you might as well just play it.
Yeah. Play it. Use your two spare parts. Let's see how it goes.
Oh, no. I think you use Frostbolt on the spare part.
You think so? On a minion?
No.
On the phase?
No, he has to go phase.
Yeah. Why would you use that over the other spare part?
Because it doesn't actually matter.
Of course it matters.
No.
Right? Oh, wait. No, it doesn't.
You get a fireball no matter what. Yeah, the Frostbolt's going to be pointed towards face no matter what.
Yeah.
Or is it? Okay. He's just hoping here that there's no way to deal one extra damage. Two extra damage to Antonio.
Well, there's Shadow Ward Death is a pretty common
he's already,
priest
he's already
right?
played one.
Oh, he did? Well, okay, played, okay, yeah. okay.
I think Mind Control is the common one.
Mind Control is, yeah. That would be such a blowout. Or the Holy Fire. If he has the Holy Fire, he can just Holy Fire that is right here and just drain in the Cabal. And there's like no way he can lose from 20.
Yeah.
24, 22 or 24
that would be pretty
with
tough.
The hero power.
What about running fireballs for Amaz?
No, that would be crazy.
Four fireballs?
That would be a total of 26 over two turns.
We have seen a lot of fireballs.
That actually would be exact lethal if he had Holy Fire two turns later. Running
and
fireball
we've seen
top
like a
decks.
Lot of games decided by a top deck fireball so far in this tournament.
Yeah.
I think that that's going to be a common thing in the future as well.
So it's kind of 50-50 that he'll draw them because he either does or he doesn't. Right?
Yeah. 50-50 on the first and 50-50 on the second.
Oh, there's the last death.
Yeah, that's huge.
Ouchies.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Circle. Sure, why not? Just keeping Lotep alive.
There's one.
But I mean, how much is there on board? There's nine. That's
enough.
Or it's one off. It's nine.
Wait, but he can right now hit Lotep with this? Or he could go, like, hit the guy in ping? And then just draw the next fireball next turn. He can hit the 7-7 and ping.
There's 20 damage on the board right now, so he actually has to fireball the Lotep here.
No, you can fireball the Dr. Boom.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so...
Because that's 9,
fireball the Dr.
10,
Boom and ping
13.
Because then with running second fireball, he would have 13 with the fireball, fireball, ping. Yeah, that has to be the plan.
Did I like, do something bad about predicting fireball runner?
I don't know. That's pretty mean for
decks.
Ignite.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I think fireball's
pretty I was just thinking back to roughly every arena match I've ever played. And
roughly everyone?
Yeah.
14 cards, so he actually has a pretty good chance of drawing the last one, too.
Yeah, that's at 7%.
How many non-fireball cards are there? There's like one
13.
Mech Warper left.
It's
okay.
Yeah, it's just over 7%.
Just over 7%?
Yeah.
I think it's like 7.2%.
It's like way more. I think it's like 65 or something. How do you not draw the fireball here?
Seriously. Lucky number 7, man.
I'm still predicting.
I'm very excited about this fireball draw.
I'm excited
he
about...
He probably has a Holy Nova.
I want a Pyromancer and
he
then like
eight
bomb damage to face.
Oh yeah.
I think here we go.
God.
Here we go.
Wow. He thought still
fireball. Oh, fireball.
That's some nice bad mana right there.
I saw it from the,
four.
From the BM.
Oh, what? We don't get to see? Oh, that's ridiculous.
It just disappeared. Like, that's not cool.
Yeah, that's not cool at all.
That's really important to know.
Yeah.
Like, would he had won if he, like, just fireball his own Lotep instead? He might have... That would have been, like, way better on the BM.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Huh?
If you fireball your own Lotep...
Yeah,
because... Oh.
And then the bombs the do the six that you need?
Yeah, but they average 5, right? So...
That would make you look so cool.
Actually, you would look really cool.
No, yeah. No.
But then he would top deck his fireball and just win right there.
No. You have to consider the perspective. This is actually important when it comes to Dr. Boom. If you're viewing from the player with Dr. Boom, the bombs actually hit for 1.
Yeah.
But if it's the other player that has Dr. Boom against you, the bomb's actually for 4. So it was actually 4 over lethal anyway.
Okay. That's actually a very like a kind of zen approach to life that you like this is reality is perception in your mind.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not real, you're not real. It's just what we perceive in each other. And
yeah, something like
Dr. Boom's damage is just perception.
Yes.
So if you look at Dr. Boom from the right angle, you will win Seat Story Cup basically.
You just gotta flip your monitor upside down sometimes.
I was meant to lose you there. All right. So he killed off Priest, or used Priest to win.
Priest is,
This is like hard to reverse.
Why is that, like,
I've never commentated one of these.
No.
Priest is never gonna win a game.
Oh, good, it's in Korean.
Like,
that's right, I can read Korean.
First game.
Wow. Let's go. Let's do it. Oh, I don't know. You don't want in Korean?
Well,
I'm fine with it. I don't care.
I think some viewers probably want to see the English version of things.
Mm-hmm. What, they don't know every single card and what it does?
No.
English UK. You got to put English US. What are you doing?
Yeah. There's going to be like bonus U's in a bunch of words.
The president's English, man. What? All right. Savit saves the day. He knows everything about Hearthstone, even how to change the language. All right. What's the strategy for next deck?
Well, we have seen a lot of players often, like when they lose the first game with a certain deck, that they're going to pick it again.
Yeah, so, we've seen that a lot. Yeah,
it's quite common, but if there's like some mind games going into it, and
I don't think as much. I think Mechmage is just whatever.
Yeah.
You draw fireballs or you don't, you know?
Mm. Yeah, he's up against the mage and a druid. But if he ignites reads that that Amaz is likely to continue with the mage and picks his own mage, maybe Amaz can figure it out and just pick a counter to the mage instead, if he has one. But the thing is that I don't really think that he has that.
He doesn't have a counter to Mechmage.
But he only has druid and warrior, so you don't want to pick your druid against the Mechmage.
No, certainly you do not.
And even warrior is kind of like not that great, I think. It depends.
Okay.
It does okay if you draw Fiery War Axe. But it's like,
yeah,
it's such a big deal.
The thing is, like, you either need Fiery War Axe to keep up or you need the Mechmage to get a bad hand.
That's true.
And, I mean, the sum of that happens quite frequently.
Yeah, Mechmage is one of those decks that sometimes just defeats itself. If you get that draw with double fireballs, you miss a drop on turn two. Something as simple as that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, he's gonna choose Mage. I made up my mind while you guys were talking about it.
We're kicking it off here. Oh, Maz looking concerned there. Yep. Uh-oh.
Wow. And he switched into Druid a little bit. Surprised, actually, that he did that, because it seemed...
And the Ignite actually switched to Mage.
Yeah, it seemed kind of obvious, actually,
that for me, Ignite,
that Mage was going to be chosen, because it doesn't have a bad matchup here.
Yeah, for Ignite, it seemed a pretty obvious pick.
Yeah.
So
why did he go into Druid, then? Like,
I actually don't know.
Because Druid doesn't beat Mech Mage.
That's a Freeze Mage.
Oh, it's a Freeze Mage?
Oh, is it really?
And Druid does pretty well against Freeze Mage.
Okay. Yeah, it is.
Well, then it's fine.
Yeah. Okay. That makes a lot more sense, then.
Yeah.
And I mean, it really doesn't, because no one knew it was Freeze Mage, most likely Mech Mage.
It wasn't seen before?
No.
No, okay. No, we didn't see
Ignite
it last time.
Ignite 3-0'd, so... Mm-hmm. Unless there was, qualifiers, some super tips from other people.
But if you 3-0'd, then three of your decks are shown.
Yeah,
It was banned in the...
It was banned in the first set.
Yeah. Oh, it was, that's right, okay.
Crip doesn't even know what game this is. He thinks we're about to go on a hell run on Diablo. No, Crip. This is Hearthstone.
There's actually no hell difficulty in Diablo anymore.
To me. All right.
That's
all right. You got me.
Yeah.
Such good news for Amaz. Like, after seeing that starting hand, if it was Mechmage, he would have been like completely destroyed.
Well, I mean, okay, so let's talk about actually this matchup. How do you like it?
Druid is favorite for sure.
For sure.
Because
the two silences, or
yeah, because of like the combos that everybody's running right now. So like, all you need is one or two minions on board, and you instantly start threatening to pop the block on early turns.
Mm-hmm.
So like, that's the main thing, I think. And also like, almost all of the druid lists include low tap, and low tap is if you time it right, it's such a blowout card against freeze mates. Let's say that.
Mm. Would you say it's like heavily favored? Or
I think it's slight.
It's
I think
slight,
Freeze Mage
slight,
has pretty good matchups against everything that isn't Kazan Mage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I would agree with that too. Like, I don't feel like Druid stomps it, but it definitely is one of the scarier ones.
Mm. Oh yeah, it's no warrior, but I think it's like the second worst matchup for the Freeze Mage.
Okay.
Not including the Kazan decks in a Kazan.
Whoever has a Kazan Mystic, whatever Kazan deck that is. Whoever decided to play a silenced Shredder. Yeah.
Okay.
Silent Shredder.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
What do you think about this, though? Do you think... it goes for a Sylvanas.
You don't like the gray?
No time for games. Yeah. Wow.
Do you really think Sylvanas is worth innervating over the Dr. Boom on the following turn?
No. I actually don't think Sylvanas is like that great overall against this either.
Well, the only other option was basically Keeper... The Acolyte.
I think it was like
you can't keep her. So in a way, it makes sense because you can't keep her because you have to have the keeper for Doomsayer. Mm-hmm. Because otherwise, you're gonna lose to a Doomsayer Frost Nova.
Mm-hmm.
So
I think it was
not that bad.
It kind of fits the curve too, right? Because it's the six mana used with that Innervate, and then he's got a five drop the next turn, and we'll see what he draws after that. But
like, Sylvanas is often a liability in this matchup.
It sure is because of the Doomsayers.
Yeah. So you can just play a bunch of shades on turn 8, and then the mage might guess that they might do a lot more damage than 3 the next turn.
Yeah.
And then you can just fireball Sylvanas after playing a Doomsayer.
Yeah. But, absolutely. Well, that actually kind of double underlines why this might be a good Sylvanas, because he doesn't have a powerful board right now. So he's like, okay, I mean, not this would be time. Crappy later on, yeah. So why don't I play it now and you deal with it now, and then I don't, you know, at least I got usage out of it.
Makes sense, but I think the biggest deal there was that otherwise his turn 4 would have sucked pretty much, so he just wants to keep up the pressure.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it seems like that Sylvanas is going to get a fair bit of damage.
Yeah, quite a bit. Well, he doesn't really have anything to deal with it.
No, that really sucks. I mean, you want to play the Emperor, but there's so much pressure, and he's already at 17 with 9 power on the board, so... So Savage Roar alone would be one off if he just chose to go Emperor here.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, that's kind of gross, man.
That's actually kind of tough, yeah. Sure is.
What to do?
I think you just gotta make the YOLO Emperor here. And try to like top deck the Frost Nova or something, then just get like crazy.
Yeah, because his hand has some really good stuff in it. Like,
yeah.
What's the best play knowing like all the cards? Is it like Doomsayer, Ice Lance?
Something like that, probably. Yeah.
Well, actually, he deals with that. He has Wrath, a 4 attack minion, and a Silence, so.
Mm-hmm. He could have dealt, yeah.
There was like no way to quite do that.
I actually, this might have been the best play, but so hard still to come back from this.
Yeah. Well, when all of your spells cost that much less, I guess anything can be doable.
Putting him down the one here. Wow. Even though he's stealing the Emperor. I like it.
Whoa.
That's actually really good.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's really a nice way to do it. Putting her opponent down to 2 and taking away the Emperor. And also like getting rid of that liability in form of Sylvanas. Mm-hmm.
That is really cool. I like that a lot.
Yeah, that was a
very good
play.
Stuff. So what now?
Isn't that the question?
That's exactly the question. I guess you ice block or you die, but then what? So you try to pick up like a Frost Nova for next turn and go like next turn you go Doomsayer, Frost Nova, Peelbot or something.
What to do?
I think you gotta go for the Arcanine like ice block. Just like see from there. Maybe play the Blood Mage for an extra draw.
You have to play the ice block before the Arcanine select.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can do it.
Yeah, but what that kind of makes it a lot worse.
No, but you're not doing it anyway this time.
Yeah.
You just want the Nova for next time.
You're getting popped no matter what, but he has both ice blocks here. He has a Healbot. It's like, as long as he draws into a Frost Nova, there's still like possibilities.
Trying to figure out if there's like
possibilities to run up against a Druid with 0 mana casting hand.
Something like that.
No. Trying to figure out if there was like some kind of play with like double Doomsayers or...
Maybe there is.
Okay, but he also needs to like Iceland, so otherwise those are not doing anything. Are they doing something? I'm trying to figure it out.
He might just be looking to...
Pretty sure they're like both gonna die now, and
oh. And yeah, of course, it just wins the game. That's
he needs to clear the Doomsayers, though.
Oh, that was smart.
No, the bombs just do the damage.
Oh, yeah, of course, the Doomsayers are gonna be dead. Okay, so that's that.
Even if they both only hit for one, guys.
No, it's 3.
No, I know. I'm saying even if
yeah, that's 3.
Low roll.
Way overkill.
That's bad manner from those bombs.
All right. Well, Amaz switches it up from being down 1. He's up 2.
No, he's not. It's 1-1.
1-1 right now.
Oh.
Yeah. Ignite won the first game.
Oh yeah, because he switched the decks completely.
Yeah. Are we dumb? Like, did Amaz just win? Amaz just won, right? Yeah, because Amaz is playing Mech Mage, isn't he?
Yep.
Okay, hold on.
All right, well...
Wait, do I even have... Yeah, I have 6. Okay.
Yeah, we gotta switch up the POVs here.
Okay. We're ready. We're good.
Yes.
Okay, so... We got Freeze Mage and Druid for Ignite. And we got, I believe it's Mech Mage... My brain isn't melting in my head.
Yeah, it's Mech Mage.
It's from Amaz. Yeah, and Warrior.
So this is actually a huge coin flip right here, because Ignite has the Freeze Mage,
Oh,
it's,
yeah,
it crushes
yeah.
the mech mage, but it's so bad against warrior. It's like, that's the best matchup and the worst one, and now it's just like,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
all mind games at this point.
Well, I think at this point, I would just like roll a die or flip a coin or something.
Another thing is that Ignite is playing the Druid, and the Druid is really good against warrior and really bad against the mage, so
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like, the winner might be decided in mind games right
yeah,
now,
it's
like
just
if they figure out what the other guy is doing.
These are two heavily favored matchups yeah. that we're looking at here. So,
like really, like the matchup is going to be really lopsided no matter what these players pick
yeah.
right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think so? Yep. Can you repeat back what we said?
There's like matchups and like there's warrior against freeze mage, which is really bad for one of the guys, probably the freeze mage.
Probably.
And yep.
Mm-hmm. Sick.
Got nice. It.
You got it. All right.
All right. Yeah, we are sorting out the spectate issue that we're having. The main issue is that you know you got to be secretive. You don't just want everyone to spectate your game on your friends list.
Certainly.
Yeah.
I hate it when people spectate my games that are on my friends list.
Mm. Those are not real friends. Spectating.
Yeah. Like show their stream and stuff yeah. and make fun of my plays. Yeah. Yeah. Kirk is just not listening to me at all
yeah,
right
he's
now.
Just ignoring you.
One second.
They have to, like, invite.
They don't. I don't think they have to invite.
Okay, I'll just restart.
They have to be against each other in the lobby for us to... They are?
Yeah, he doesn't have the spectate thing either.
Yeah. All right, we'll restart this. There's Ignite.
We're basically making like even harder for them. That's what we do here. We put even more pressure.
For who?
The players.
Oh.
You know, they're just not doing the spectate stuff, right? You're just not doing it.
They don't even know what they're doing, man.
Yeah. Actually, they might not actually know what they're doing.
Okay, so I'm supposed to be going on 6.
Mm-hmm. Eventually.
They are not in a game against each other right now.
No.
Because I can challenge, which means they are not.
Oh, they? Yeah, that's true. They're probably the ones that are bugged.
Yeah, they're the ones. It's not us.
Okay.
You and I are perfect.
Wow. Thanks, bro.
Yeah. Well, I was talking to Savitz, but
You're all right, too.
You're okay.
Mm.
I kind of like you. So,
okay.
Anyways, what do you think so far? You guys having a lot of fun at SeatStory?
Well, this is like the best yep. stuff for like player perspective. Like, there's a lot of great events, but like these house cups are just, at least that's my personal opinion. I just love this stuff.
I like, think every pro always says that in StarCraft and Hearthstone. It's just like, this is so much fun to just chill here with all your friends.
My
and
only
just play.
Complaint is that we haven't really seen that many like super crazy decks. It's just like the only super crazy decks are like Priest because there basically is no standard
Gaara's
Priest
decks
anymore.
Are pretty wild.
Yeah.
Gaara's got some wild stuff.
Some guy brought the Acro Paladin on day one.
Yeah.
No.
No.
No one brought that.
Cool.
What are you talking about?
I saw that last week. It's fine.
Yeah, I've been playing with and against that on the ladder for 2 weeks now. Come on. Come on.
You probably have. I know you
actually,
like to
try. I got getting down to like 50 health with that this morning.
Nice.
Yeah, on heroic.
Did you like run out of cards in your deck?
Almost.
Yeah.
Well, eventually it's like I didn't have another divine favor.
Mm-hmm.
And then I could spend like 3 mana one of the turns, and I was like, and that happened twice
yeah.
in a row, and I died.
You gotta spend all your mana on that.
Yeah.
You gotta spend all your mana and deal with like the 10 damage to all enemy characters buff. Yeah.
I still haven't tried it out.
Okay. It's good, except that it's kind of easy.
Did you beat all the heroics yet?
Yeah.
Light Wolf? Freeze Mage?
No, I used Mal'Ganis Demon Lock with Pandas.
Oh, that's cool.
So the Pandas beat Geddon, and then I queued up with that deck against the last boss, which is not a good idea because it was the wrong deck. But apparently 3 Mal'Ganis just beats anything.
It was.
It's pretty nice.
Yeah.
How big does that even make them? Like +4,
oh,
+4?
Oh, I flipped one, so it was like a 14-17 or something.
Oh, wow. Okay, here we go. We can actually observe now.
Okay.
Everything's fixed. There's some computer smarties down here. And it looks like Amaz goes to the round of 16.
Yes.
Well, not yet. Not with that hand.
No, with that hand, too. Yeah.
Should be good enough.
Yeah. Well, it's not so much the hand crypt as you see the hero power down
there.
Yeah. That's hero power. That can be a problem.
If you ignite, you got to feel like pretty bad right now.
If you're ignite, I think you're mulliganing your entire hand looking for Tarzan.
Yeah, pretty much. That's what I did when I played against Warrior.
Yeah.
Didn't get it. Got crushed.
Yeah.
But even with Tarzan, you sometimes get crushed.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's...
I really think Amaz's like hand is terrible.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah. I really don't think it matters. It's like not even what being you facetious. Even? It's like as long as he just armors a whole lot, that's it. You just get out of range, yeah. Right? Unless a perfect Tarzan lines up like 7 fireballs or something.
Do you
think
it's a good idea to drop the Thalnos here?
Yeah.
It's like what? 6 extra damage.
Oh, God, yeah. He adds a lot of damage if you Tarzan stuff, right? So... Mm-hmm. I guess he just wants to cycle through.
Yeah, he's trying to find the cycle here for like a mad scientist and things like that.
Amaz is going to play this very patiently again, it seems. The armor smith is going to be held back until he can gain a lot of armor immediately off of it.
Yeah, can't blame him for that. It's usually a good way to do this. You don't want it to die early on just to like a frostbolt ping or something, because it's like a... It's
do you think it's actually worth it to frostbolt ping that? What to
do? Can be. Mm. I mean, you've got to deal with it. If you don't, or fireball or something, because like you waste the frostbolt, kind of like you use it there. But if you don't use it on that, the armorsmith is gonna be like 6 armor. Or so, it's like if you fireball the armorsmith, it's like okay, they would still heal for 6 from it. It's a bit. It depends on the situation a bit, but yeah. If you have a chance, you should deal with it.
Yeah.
Amaz is running this warrior with shredders as well. I didn't quite catch the round before this, where I guess we learned this already.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's everything else is very standard about it, though. Yeah, it's just control warrior with shredders, really.
Mm-hmm. I would have probably just went for the shredder here. I mean, you do.
Yeah, but if you shredder, you can't armor up, and I thought that's how you win the game.
A lot of players do think that it's good to armor up every time, but playing the shredder here would look like it's gonna deal like 16 damage. So
yeah, I actually really like the armoring up every turn. But if you're playing the shredder, like just put him out there. It's such a pain for them to deal
plus
with.
Plus, there's probably an armorsmith in the shredder anyway.
It probably is.
It looks like he's gonna miss an armor up somewhere along the line anyway, unless he plays the big game hunter next turn. Yeah,
looks good. Big game armor up. What to do? You guys just told me how to play the class, and you guys are saying something different now.
Oh, sorry.
All right, let's reevaluate. So you have to armor up every turn, but you can miss 2 armor ups. How's that?
You can miss. Okay, 2 is the max. You can miss 1 easily, and like 2 if you have like really good things to play.
Yeah, yeah. And I think the shredder is one of those really good things where it's like, well, this is.
It's a lot of power.
A threat that just sits around there.
Like if you got it down on turn 4, it's just like they gotta almost frostbolt it. Or it's otherwise it's gonna deal with 16.
Shield slam.
Well, you could do that with the fire war axe.
No, I think I like the fire war axe into the 2/2 and then execute the doomsayer. We're not gonna get.
Yeah, you're right.
From
the execute is not that useful.
Mm-hmm. That's nice accolade.
You gotta save like 1 removal at least.
Yeah.
I wouldn't really blame him for shield slamming there either. I don't think it would have been that bad, but I mean, does feel a little bit bad to use both the execute and the shield slam in case there's something like an early Antonidas.
What do you think about this anti-kill bot, Savis?
Well,
it's been getting some hate. I think Rayned gave it some.
Well, it's a deck card, and in some matchup it's really good. So it's kind of like the way I see it is like what other decks are you bringing to the format? Because like I've also brought in my decks, but that's like. Because it's Conquest format, and I felt like a lot of my other decks are really good against aggressive decks. So the way that I was approaching the thing is that I want to have the Freeze Mage a little bit like specifically designed to be the aggressive deck, so all of my lineup is good against that, and if somebody brings a Face Hunter against me, I can just 3-0 that. Mm. So it's like the deck card that you choose to go with should complement the other lineup of decks that you're bringing. And I would have to think about it. Ignite did have Priest, so I think it's a good tech card in Ignite's lists. But it's, in this matchup, in this situation, it's definitely not a good card at all.
You think Ice Barrier is better?
Usually it's like two Ice Barriers anyway, but the other deck cards are like a second Flame Strike to beat Rogues or...
Yeah.
Or well, I've even tried like a Big Game Hunter in some matchup, because that makes Warlock matchup specifically like really, really good when you play against Handlock. It's absolutely amazing.
Is anyone actually play a Polymorph in this anymore?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. I actually do like a Polymorph and Freeze Mage when I can fit one, but the BGH is fine. Is the thing is, if they play Rag, you're just like, oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's like the heal, but it's really
Rag
like
is like 8 armor and 8 damage. It's like so, because you have to kill it with...
That's a really good holy fire.
Yeah. It's a really good holy fire.
But about the Polymorph, I think it's like that the Big Game Hunter is just better, because the Arachnos is one of those cards that... Or Dr. Boom, which the mage can sometimes struggle to deal with.
Yeah, yeah.
So it gives you like a chance. But it's like... I feel like 28 out of 30 cards in the Freeze Mage are exactly the same, and just like choosing the last one is like depending on what else you're bringing.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Shield Slam Attack, Tech Belcher, you think?
Yeah, it must be.
But he's gonna miss another armor.
Well, that's his two armors miss, right?
Was that the first one or the second one?
It's the third.
I think that's actually the third armor.
He might actually lose the game here.
Yeah.
Wow, well, that's the card he wanted to see.
Yep, insta drops that. And that is already a lot of fireballs that he can gain.
This
Look at that. For one mana.
The crazy thing is, if you actually Ice Lance the Shredder, Tarson might stay alive.
Yeah, it actually would have, but how do you know that?
Yeah,
you gotta save it for the Antonidas. This is actually one of those games that the mage is winning right now.
Yeah.
Because he has everything he needs. He has Thorson, he has Antonidas, he has Alexstrasza. And the warrior has only gained a few armor. And the hand from the warrior sucks. If I was a gambling man, I would put my money on the freeze mage right now.
Yeah,
Armorsmith is going to do a lot, though.
That hand looks pretty darn good. The Alexstrasza, too. Mm-hmm. It's... You know what I love is when Tarzan also gets like Alexstrasza and Ice Block in your hand, gets it down to 2 and 8.
That
is a
great surprised about. Why would you play the Belcher over Boom?
It's the armor up thing, because he knows that he already
missed
three.
Yeah, but with Armorsmith, the two you're basically guaranteed to get back off the two Boom bot targets.
Yeah,
like
that's
if you
true.
Get Flame Strike, that's the two armor that you just missed, and
makes
Boom is so much more aggressive.
Yeah, you are right about that. You are right about that. But I guess
he figures out
he can do it the next turn or something.
Yeah, like the Boom is still going to be good next turn, and next turn he can also armor up with it. So I guess that's the line of thinking.
But if you get Flame Strike here, this is perfect Flame Strike. With Tharson, it would be a 6 mana Flame Strike.
Oh, that's pretty good. Ping. And I agree with you. I think it would be better.
Mm. You think it's Alistraza time?
Could be. I mean, the Blizzard is not that great. What else? I don't think there's anything else. Just drop it and hope that there's no Big Game Hunter or another removal. Like, if there was no other hard removal, that would actually get a lot of job done. Like, a lot of work.
Shield Maiden?
I wouldn't Shield Maiden here. I'd BGH armor up.
Yeah, I think so, though.
Yeah.
Gotta get that armor, man. Because there's no way for him to one-shot you anyways. Like, unless... Well, actually, if his hand was perfect for Tarzan, I guess... But he already lost Thalnos, so it'd be like...
Well, it looks like he's throwing away some creatures that gain more armor through Armorsmith.
Mm.
He's actually sconcering it.
More than that.
Look, the mage is at 44 HP right now. So if you're the warrior, you know that you have just turtle up here. Like, there's no way you can choose to take any kind of aggressive approach at this point. You just have to like out-heal all the damage.
Okay, that's the card. That's Fireball time. Fireball is in season right now, guys. Antonidas, Ice Lance, Frostbolt, Coin, Arcane Intellect. Yep.
Does he have enough mana for that? 10,
yeah,
3, 4?
That's
four.
Exact
yeah,
that's mana puts you on 9 cards.
That's pretty sick. I like it. Yeah,
it's pretty
good.
Yeah. 4 Fireballs and...
That's crazy.
How do you lose from there? Let's see if he sees it.
This is Ignite's tournament, guys.
Yeah. Seems like he's going for it. That's so sick. I mean, if you are beating a warrior with freeze mage, I think you're going to win the entire thing.
Yeah. Oh, man. This is insane. And he's got two big-ass minions he has to deal with now, too.
That it's all about the Emperor in this matchup. Like we talked about it with some other players about this particular matchup. And it used to be like almost like 95% for the Warrior, or maybe even more. But now it's like we landed on somewhere between 15 and 20%, depending on how you draw. Yeah. And Ignite got pretty much the perfect draw. He got the Alex Ruasa early to not allow the Warrior to have too much time. He got the Emperor, and he got the combos required for the Antonides to draw the fireballs.
Oh, he's trying to save everything.
Wow. But there's the brawl. This is actually going to be a huge brawl turn right
here. Yeah.
He has to take out the Antonides, and the brawl is the only way to do it.
That was a cool play.
There's absolutely no way he can leave up the Antonides.
Well, sometimes the 20% brawl does leave up the Antonitis.
Yeah, I mean,
sometimes.
I'm actually pretty convinced that the Antonitis is going to win this one.
I'm pretty convinced that Armorsmith is going to win.
It's completely in line of how the RNG has been for Ignite. So it does make a lot of sense that the Antonitis wins. It's like he was drawing so well earlier already.
Yeah, no, this is his tournament, man. He's got it.
I think in this spot, you still just don't play actual fireballs. You play like Blizzard and then Fireball Face.
Yeah.
Sure.
There's no reason not to, right?
A Blizzard at least, but one fireball.
He's going to start discarding cards, but who cares?
Yeah, what does it matter?
Your hand is pretty good, actually. When you have that many red cards with blue borders, I think you're well off.
Yeah, those are pretty good.
Those are the good ones.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
I can't even believe it.
So do you Dr. Boom, Ember, Shield Maiden, or Concede?
I think you go with Concede.
It looks like the best.
How much damage is
Concede
there?
Concede is the best player.
Yeah,
I think so.
12, 24, 30. There's 40 direct damage in hand.
Wow.
Soon to be way more.
And he gets it. Like, those fireballs are just going to get replaced.
Yeah.
Aha.
Oh my god. Only he could get Tree of Life. When's that dragon coming out that gives
Actually,
you
if he draws shield block, he has another turn. Nope, no shield block.
I mean, I guess he survives one more turn with the No, he doesn't, actually, no.
Yeah,
it would have been exactly 13. It would have been to 13, but that's not it.
Wow. Alright.
Freeze Mage. Taking out the Warrior.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Alright, so Ignite just goes with his Druid, obviously.
Yep.
As he does have to. And now, I would imagine Amaz is just going to switch to Mech Mage,
yeah,
get that
for
free
sure.
win, and then...
You think that's that free of a win?
It's not a free win.
No,
I thought we just saw a free win that didn't end up being a free win.
Hey man, this is Ignite's tournament.
But it's pretty bad for the Druid because of like the meter entities, because Druids always struggle against the mirror entity, so you don't have the small minions to play into that, and you're limited on the mana. But I mean, if Druid does draw like two innervates and like the right combination of cards, it's doable, but it's really hard.
Or again, if the Mech Mage just draws straight garbage.
Oh yeah, that's another one. Like two fireballs, two frostballs in the starting hand.
Yeah, normally where you want to draw your fireballs are as your last two cards that you need to win the game. That's exactly
where
you want
them. It's you're about to die, and the only card you need is the one fireball left in the deck.
We've seen
and
it two or three
times.
Time.
That's when you drive.
Yeah. It's a good way. It makes it interesting.
Oh, Warrior Mirror.
Okay.
I thought there was a Druid that was supposed to be being played here. Did I miss something?
We apparently had Ignite's deck strong here. Okay. Our choices. This is your fault. It's even right on the overlay. So Ignite has a Warrior.
I don't even know how that happened. I'm so confused. Oh, yeah. You did have a Warrior. What did I write down?
You just Druid.
I wrote down Druid. Yeah,
it was Amaz who played
the
Druid. Right?
That was stupid.
Yeah.
That changes everything. All right.
Man, this Conquest format really just makes casters look like idiots.
Yeah. This is my first time casting Conquest, actually.
Yeah, me too.
Wow.
Yeah. So. Okay, Warrior versus Warrior. You guys ready for some armor pass?
Oh, yeah.
It's my favorite.
Well, we know that Amaz is running the Shredder version. I think the Shredder version is pretty powerful compared to the normal.
Well, there's like two different schools of thought that I've seen in the past on playing Warrior versus Warrior. One, you put the pressure on and you just have less cards in your hand all game, and the other is you try to play like the greedy control style. And I prefer the
Amaz,
the pressure
Amaz
on.
Has the pressure deck, but the way we've seen him play is the slow way.
But I think he has to look at this and say, well, I have shredders in here. I have to be the guy that's putting on the pressure, you know?
Wow, well, that's a pretty good draw.
I absolutely hate that coin acolyte play. I would never do it.
Well, it was great until the fairy war axe off the top happened.
In this match, I don't play him till I draw something off of him, generally. Mm-hmm. I don't ever like to put that guy down unless, like, I'm using the second charge on a death spite or, you know.
Yeah, I really like the coin. It just gives you, like, that emperor turn one turn earlier.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. This drawing is quite important. Okay.
Talking about that aggressive strategy that you... By the way, I completely agree with you. That's like... It's just two ways to play it. And that Shredder is one of the key cards if you want to pull off the aggressive strategy. Because most warriors don't run it, but it's like that turn where you use the armor pass. And instead of armor passing, you add a minion which needs to be killed twice. So you can get ahead on the board.
Oh,
that's not bad. I mean,
you think there's other pirates in that deck?
No,
but I think there are. It's just hidden in the other shredder.
Oh, but
nice.
The thing is, there's no way to play it and get the 2 damage.
But, no, it's not about playing. It's summoned.
No. It doesn't do the damage if it comes out of a shredder.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Absolutely, it does.
Whenever you summon a pirate, deal 2 damage to a random enemy.
Yeah, summon means
summon a random minion.
Whoa! What's that? I just blew Artosis' head. That's why he's not talking right now.
You might be right, yeah. Okay, yeah, you're right. Okay, never
Do
mind.
Do you know how much Arena I've played? I've seen that at least once.
Wow. At least once. At least one whole time, Crip?
Yep.
Whoa.
Do you cruel thought? Oh.
What?
That was a bit weird.
Oh, I'm surprised that he chose to deal with it this way.
I would have just like it would have been strictly better to just cruel dusk your own cannon. It would have been a 4-1, and he would also get like less armor.
Yeah, and
just kill that 2-2 with your weapon. You would have a 4-1.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
so
that was
this is
that
basically
was strictly
a BM play.
Not as good.
And, that was a mistake from.
And look at this. If this was a 4-1, you know how different this turn is?
Yeah.
Like infinity different.
That sucks.
Well, now he's. I guess he's just gonna death spite it. Like.
Sylvanas pretty good against that too.
I like Tarzan.
You like Tarzan here?
Yeah. Well, Tarzan's always great, but I would probably lean towards the Sylvanas. Just because of like the you're kind of guaranteed to get something out of the Shredder. So there's like it's almost like stops your opponent from playing anything next turn. Like they can't go shield mage.
Oh yeah, you know what? I think you're actually right.
Tarzan.
But it's like you can't call a Tarzan play bad ever. It's like such a powerful card.
Yeah.
Now all your following turns are gonna
be
more.
He is just undermining my excellent calls.
Really? This is all a conspiracy against you.
Yeah.
And you know what's really funny is that you're like the most sarcastic laid back guy and like super nice and stuff, but I'm sure you have some really crazy hardcore fans that are like, I don't like the way they're talking to Crip right now. I think he's way smarter than them. I know that that's the case. I know the internet. I know people.
On a scale from not offended to offended.
What? This game is rigged. So this game is rigged.
How many different cards? There was 67 or something. What are the chances both of them get the cannon? I mean, one could argue that we only start counting after
there's
the
There's going to be
one,
a pirate. The pirate is coming, guys.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, man.
You like to brawl? You generally want to brawl out Dr. Boom.
Nah, you don't brawl here. I mean, you just the board is almost even already. Developing some stuff is pretty great. Gets straight the cannon. Oh, but now he won't get the battle cry from the other pirate that he's getting from. But there's only one shredder, I think. So.
Yeah, but he's gonna get a shredder now. Oh. And then he's gonna brawl, and it's gonna get a pirate. It's gonna kill the pirate, and then the 2-3 is gonna stay alive.
Okay.
Yep.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
This is a great way to commentate Hearthstone. I'm like, this is the ridiculous thing that's gonna happen next.
So,
dude, look at that. I love with these warrior decks that we've seen now with Tarzan, like, reducing the cost of either Brawl or Sylvanas just for these sick, insane plays that we were all thankful before the mana didn't line up on.
It didn't work out for Gera, though.
No, it
didn't
at that time.
His Brawl Sylvanas play on his Priest ended up not working out.
Yeah. That's pretty sad.
Something
huh?
tiny. Yeah. He got, like, a 2-2 or something from it.
What now? Yeah.
What now? That's the question. Do you boom here?
Well, boom is better than Shield Maiden, so it's boom or nothing, I guess.
I like nothing. I mean,
you like nothing?
I don't know. Like, it feels so weird because your ship's cannon is gonna go down to one, and like the boom is just gonna get wrecked by.
You can clear the board with execute and shield slam.
Execute.
Wow.
That's true. So you shield slam and then execute on the armors.
No. You attack and execute and then you armor up shield slam.
Oh yeah. Oh well. I guess might as well throw it out there. Doesn't feel that great. It's a really good turn for the Acolyte.
I think you just brawl here.
Yeah.
But I mean, what if you play the Dr. Boom and the Acolyte and then just like hit that Dr. Boom with the weapon? You
oh
only need
my
to,
god.
Like,
that's chaos is what happens.
Because that's like...
I would love that though. That's awesome.
You would only need to hit like one boom button. But then your own boom gets like executed easily and I don't know. I don't know if it would be good, but...
Nope. Four. And... Two, what? Was
that
a
two to the face was a little bit off.
Yeah.
That was not the proper boombot hit.
Maybe Acolyte just
I liked your play though, Savitz, with the playing the boom there. That would have been really like just like a million armor and just volleyball craziness. You could have hit his boom with your face and like probably killed it off with your bombs.
Just a bit of risky though. Yeah. Like if the boom was don't hit it, then just like 7-2 Dr. Boom on the board, which is gonna trade for your 7-6.
Risks are the best. That's how you win.
Overall, probably that play would have been kind of bad.
Yeah. Well, you know, I said I like brawl from one player, now I like brawl from the other player.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, the only bad outcome is he gets to keep his Dr. Boom, and if he does, then he loses an Acolyte draw.
That's right. The draws are pretty big in this. The brawl is one of those cards that quite often is played against.
This is where his lock room stays alive for a second before the bombs finish it off.
Whoa!
Oh, 7-face though. That's fair.
That seems all right. Well, he just did 7-face himself. This boom.
So that's fair.
Yeah. It all worked. It worked out.
I think I like Alistraza here. Spam. Slam it.
That's really aggressive, but I would probably lean towards the Sylvanas. Because it's like, the Dr. Boom is at 6, so you're kind of guaranteed to get something out of your Sylvanas.
And it like also sludge like
the thing about that is that it kind of messes up the next turn in a way.
There we go.
Why would you sludge?
I would sludge here.
Why?
Because it softens up Dr. Boom so you can kill with the War Axe.
Okay.
It does.
It does, does it not?
You can't dispute that.
It does.
Yeah.
It does do that. Thank you. Yes, I am right. Thank you.
But like, it's so defensive. I just like in order to like turn this around, I feel like you got to do the Sylvanas. But I guess it also makes sense that you save it for the brawl, because you do have the discount on Sylvanas. So,
well, that's the tricky thing. You're not really going to be expecting that as much as well.
No. Yeah. That's like probably why he did this too, because of the brawl combo.
But whoa! Softened.
Yeah, look at him. But look at the amount of health he has, and look at how much damage Fire War Axe does, and tell me that's
but look
not
at those
match.
Two belchers real quick.
Yeah, he can protect the damage.
Oh, no! That would be terrible. Imagine if he'd probably do that, too.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So that didn't work out so well.
No.
This is where I X off Hearthstone and leave my room. Come back.
Do you think
your
there's a chance we'll see the Sylvanas brawl here? And he's going to end up with two slimes at the end of the turn?
I mean, all the other options seem really bad too, but it's like, I feel like if you do it now, then you don't really have a good
you
way to win.
You know what I think would have been really good? Alistraza last turn.
Definitely would have been better than what we see here.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Definitely. You are very right about that. I take it all back. That sludge belcher just wasn't right.
Yeah.
Well, it did do what it was supposed to.
I think you just drop the Sylvanas here and like maybe armor up and pass, or maybe do the shield block too. But I think only like you definitely play the Sylvanas. I think because like, there's two big minions on the board right now. Like the Sylvanas seems like guaranteed value. You don't have to do the combo necessarily. There's like no reason you would do those at the same turn.
Oh man.
Armor up, Sylvanas pass, all good. It sets it up pretty nicely. That's so awkward to deal with right now. Hmm. Like, what do you do if you ignite here?
There's not ignore no, there's ignore no, it?
I guess.
I'd go with ignore it.
But then he gets wrecked by the brawl. Because you gotta also like you kind of have to play another minion.
Yeah, I think I would ignore it as well.
If you're really good at the game, you're gonna shield block into your own Sylvanas, and then just like play shield it and slam. Shield slam it. Yeah,
that's really good really good.
Aww. Yeah, screw it. Take away 7 of his armor. It's fine.
Yeah, you can't play more stuff here because of the potential pro.
Yeah.
You can't even Belcher, you think?
No.
No, I don't think so.
You can't give him that much brawl value.
But it's like, it doesn't feel that great, but you're already kind of ahead on the board. So your opponent is in a, like the one who needs to make a move. And it's a warrior on warrior, so it's like you're ahead, so just like take it easy. No, don't take any risks. Mm. All right, so here. What
now? You can take the boom.
You could.
But, the 7-3 boom, I don't think I want it when he has that many cards in hand.
That 7-3 boom has done 21 damage without his boom bots, which that's I think true. Have also done another 7.
Yeah, wow. That's 28 insane. Damage boom right there.
Which yeah. is still alive, by the way. Well, that part's important. 28 so far.
And now it's going to be 35.
35.
One or another.
Actually, it's not just going to trade for Sylvanas.
Yeah, it definitely is going to trade here. Then he's going to make a new board with most likely Shield Maiden.
Yeah.
Like, it's he has 2 of those. He doesn't need the armor up thingy like from the other one. So he does have the Shield Slam, but he also
right, good.
Has the 18 already.
Now we have Alistraza. Alistraza Shield Slam.
Yes, I like it. Mm-hmm. Or we just can go for it.
You can just Acolyte.
Even the weapon is ready there.
No. We can play. We can play slow if we want.
No, you don't want to play the Alistraza.
No, I want to play slow.
No, you do the Alistraza for 3, man.
I want an Acolyte.
That's like a fire elemental to the face.
No, I think the Acolyte's good. Do you know how many cards you get off that Acolyte?
In this situation, not
one.
So many. What?
Yeah.
Okay.
You really want that card?
That's
huh?
so good. I mean, if it's a good one, I guess it's worth it.
Here comes the Acolyte.
Well, obviously. I mean, yeah, it's either that or pass.
Yeah, yeah, he does need to get the cycle, so I would be really surprised. If he keeps it here... It's
there
like
we go. Play predicted.
Damn, dude.
You did it.
You really spot on today.
Yeah, but you know what he did earlier was that terrible Sludge Belcher play that I said he should do, so...
That's how I guessed that.
Ah, that's smart.
Yeah.
All right. So,
No, you don't. No, no way.
Why not?
Because that would deal too much damage.
Oh.
Like when the Alistraza was really on the inside, it was the best play not to play it.
I see. It's like 1.5 Pyroblast. Mm-hmm. And,
it's pretty sick. Well, you know what it is exactly? It's 2 Fireballs and a Frostbolt, which is more fitting for this time of Hearthstone.
What? I guess.
I genuinely think it's still the best play to just Shield Slam Alistraza again.
Yeah, totally agree.
Dunk run the Acolyte.
Yeah, run your Acolyte right in. Run him in first, obviously.
The thing is, if both warriors are like running low on cards and they have like not that many left and they still have a lot of life left, drawing a lot of cards might be a bad thing.
That's true.
Yeah, it can go to fatigue.
10 and 11. It's kind of even right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but with that many cards in hand... It liking it for Ignite.
Mm-hmm. I don't know why he went face with the weapon there. Like this, DM seems like drilling the tree when your opponent is at over 30 is not that big of a deal.
Yeah.
And he doesn't have a new weapon to replace the...
Well, he does have a
oh,
weapon.
Oh, he does
he
have
a...
Okay.
Play it.
Oh, I actually missed that. I was looking at the wrong player. Yeah. Getting confused because it's 2 warriors. Okay, so that's why he did it, obviously.
Yeah.
Well, this is the issue right now. Like... Amaz is behind on the cards in hand, but he's about even on the cards in the deck. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And no one's really doing anything.
No, this is
so
pretty slow-paced.
The fatigue game is Ignites right now.
Yes. By a lot. I mean, Ignite has answers for days. He can just kill
also,
everything. Like two executes.
I'm pretty sure Baron Geddon is always played as a bonus legendary, which means
is.
Ignite is playing the slower deck, which also
yep.
makes him favored in the...
It's very true. Amaz does not have any bonus legendaries. Like, he just has the regular set.
I think we saw his entire deck against Garrus Priest, and there was no Ysera or anything like that.
Nope. It was just completely standard with Shredders. That was it.
So, Fiery Axe. And?
Gidden. I think I'd give him the card.
Yeah, absolutely agreed on that. When you're getting this low and you have that many... Like, he has every answer. Like, Amaz can draw everything in his deck, and he can basically deal with it all. So I would really like for him to just hit the face of Shield Maiden with this, play Geddon, and just be like, all right, cool.
Seems like
take two cards off that. That's fine.
Seems like a super heavy Shield Slam. Poor Shield Maiden.
Yeah.
20.
Ouch. That hurts.
Wait. Oh, no, he couldn't have Shield Slam face.
Oh.
Oh.
Chat, calm down.
One day, shield slamming face will be a thing.
What now?
Yeah, I think they should rework that card.
Oh, yeah, definitely. OTK Warrior.
It's actually like... I think in one of the first like few weeks of Hearthstone, I was talking about how bad the card is, and they should do something really cool with it, like it does the damage to all enemy characters instead.
That seems balanced.
Whoa, you were really good at Hearthstone, weren't you?
I was spot on that card.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You got it right, yeah.
This is where the Shield Maiden dies to Ragnaros. That's the best target.
Orange Jesus.
There you go.
Oh, that's the best one.
Yeah. Wow. You're really on fire today, Crip.
Yeah.
You're nailing everything.
I think big game is quite fair. Like, you don't have to be winning by much, but if you're just winning, you just chip out that armor again and again and again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's really hard to turn it around for Amaz right now. Like, Ignite is the one with advantage all the time.
Yeah. Well, Amaz tried to get aggressive there, but I think actually the play that might have really swung the game was that Sludge Belcher that was just like completely worthless. It did nothing.
Maybe. It was,
such a throwaway.
And the Isle of Stress is still there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It might be useful when Amaz hits sub 15 life, yeah. But other than that, it's no longer useful.
It's not that. It's like, it's really hard to use it anymore. It's just like, even though these games are so long, I feel like Ignite is like slowly just grinding it out.
Wait, you have, like, now we're at 8 and 7, like Amaz is ahead one card because of that Acolyte. So. He's losing the card, the board, the life battle, the armor battle, and the fatigue game.
Yeah, like every. Okay, let's see.
Wow, that Belcher is left up.
Oh. But I do agree with the play kind of, because he's like doing so poorly that he kind of has to take some chances.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know like how else you're gonna like turn it around. Even though that was like not a good play, but it's like it's desperate times call for desperate measures.
Yeah, his hand is not very exciting.
Hmm. Armor up!
Yep. Don't really need to do anything else.
No.
Slowly grinding it with those. You can attack with...
I don't even like the Sylvanas.
I don't think he needs it. But he did just see a brawl, so he knows that it's like getting killed.
Yeah.
I don't mind it. I probably would not play it, but I don't mind it at all. I think it's fine. It's a lot of damage. It doesn't die to that, but it's like... Amaz is going so low.
That's why we save the Alistraza.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
So he can afford... Oh, but how much is that? 12 to 20 damage.
Mm-hmm.
Do you go for it?
Yeah, the funny thing is, it counters the Alistraza play if you do.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there could be Alistraza execute, and then that would just like. But no, but he can't like, he can't attack first because he goes to 5, so he can't use the weapon and Alistraza afterwards.
That's what
because
I meant.
Yeah. Gotcha.
It counters the Alistraza
gotcha.
Play.
Yeah. So I guess you just go for it. I mean, how do you lose from there?
If you play Rag, you attack face. If you.
Oh yeah.
If you don't want to play Rag, then it's fine. You just don't attack face.
Yep. Mm. What can go wrong if you drop it here.
I don't think
Brawl
anything.
Is already gone.
You'd have to put you playing two Brawls. Like, that would be it.
Deathwing.
Deathwing. Oh, good old Deathwing. But you still have, like, double execute.
Oh, no, you actually take Deathwing. Never mind. That's fine.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wait, what?
What? Well, I guess he wants to be ready to execute anything that comes out because he knows his opponent has to do something.
Yeah, it has to be because of the executes. Okay.
Oh.
How good is that? Trying to figure it out. Because he gets an extra. He can first take that out, and with the Harrison, he gets an extra whirlwind from the opponent's weapon. So that's actually going to be an easy way to clear that.
Wow. That really backfired.
Well, that's a card.
All right. It's time for Rag to go through this.
Yeah. I mean, Ignite has
Rag. No, it's a 50-50. And it's a good 50-50. Oh, it's...
Yeah, he can execute.
I'd even shield slam.
Sure.
Well, I mean, it's 50-50 either way if you shield slam or not.
That's true. Maybe you don't.
I mean, shield slam at all.
Just give it. Like, why would you do?
See, it would have just hit the slime, and then you'd feel really dumb.
All right.
That's the big game.
All right.
This is not over yet.
No, it's not.
Wow. They've gotten a lot quicker, though.
There actually might be a comeback in the making here. Seems unlikely, but it's still doable. But Ignite will draw into his Chrome eventually. Oh, okay.
Nope.
I mean, this is an obvious get-in, right?
Yep. Just clears the taunt.
That's going to be a pain to get rid of.
What's going to be a pain is activating Grimash for that 25 damage shield slam.
That's why you got to wait a while.
Have you ever seen that happen? Like somebody shield slamming for a tiny bit too much? Yeah, me too.
What was it? I think it was like some play with Armorsmith. And then like attack into some taunts. Mm-hmm. And then they do Grom shield slam. And then shield slams a little bit too much.
Ouch.
Alright. Draw.
That's the Alex Sosa. And the game looks to be somewhat even.
Yeah, look at this.
Two cards and three cards. Okay, so Amaz is still in pretty bad shape. Mm. He has less cards and he's also slightly behind on the board. And on the life totals. And on the cards in the hand. Okay, yeah.
So not much has changed.
Okay, not really that much. I'm almost out of cards. Okay, that better be a good one because he doesn't have much more left.
Oh, whoa, if he gets Cruel Task, he can chip away at roughly 1/5 of Ignite's health.
Whoa!
But I don't think there's a Cruel Task in the deck left.
Can't quite remember.
I think you're right. I don't think there is one.
Probably not. No, he used one to like before he brawled. And
Yeah. And I think there was one used right before that.
I think so, yeah. Not sure.
Yeah, no, he used that this game for that really weird play where he could have had the 4-1.
Oh, yeah. That's true.
Right.
Yeah, but he could have used it on the cannon. What now? Do you think it snowballed from there? Because it feels like Amaz has been behind all game. Like,
yeah, well, there was definitely a few mistakes just in the early game overall.
I think actually Artosa's Sludge Belcher play just lost tempo so hard.
Yeah, but also like the turn where he couldn't deal with the 4-3 with a 4-1 cannon was actually a pain in the ass also.
It was pretty big. Well.
Dacromash.
Well, it's not getting that much better. I think Grimash just hits the shredder here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, Amaz with Chrome Execute and Ignite with Chrome Execute. But Ignite also with two cards and weapon.
HP and armor.
So, are you trying to say Ignite is favored here?
No, slightly, yeah.
It depends on the stability of the network connection.
Absolutely. Oh.
Okay. Wait, what?
Did that?
He knows
that there's the execute left. Nice.
Very
but
well
it doesn't really matter. Like, he could have just let it get executed too, and he would win the fatigue. Ignite, 3-1, moving on.
Wow. Ignite just crushing so far. That's, like, very surprising. Like, I really considered this one of the two hardest groups, looking at just the groups on paper. And, Ignite was considered the hardest group. Yeah, I think it was like D, a lot of people are really respecting as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So. I mean, Strife getting 0-2, that has to be kind of tough group. Yeah.
Now, I think we will get to see the losers match, which, like, I hope we didn't miss it. I know sometimes we do losers match while we do the winners match. I hope this was not one of those times.
Okay, we are showing it.
We are showing it.
That's a really good match, too.
I mean, it's Gera and Thais, which, in my opinion, were, like, the two favorite players.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah. I'm so excited to see that Gaara's Druid deck especially.
But they're basically both facing elimination.
Yeah.
So they're going to bring whatever they got into this.
That's going to be fun, man.
I saw Thais taking notes before the match there, and he was like being really careful about it, writing down every single card, thinking about the matchups. Mm-hmm. So this is like the do or die, and should be a good matchup.
Yeah, Ignite here. Why are you beating everybody like this?
Yeah, man, do you just want to sit on that couch all day? Because we could just arrange that.
Sorry. Right in front of your mouth.
Not going to be another Artosis pulls up.
Yeah,
the
there's
mic,
going to be if you keep it right in front of your mouth.
All
right,
like this?
There you go.
There you go. Perfect. Okay. Yeah.
So
I was saying you're sitting on that couch a lot today.
Which couch?
On the winner's side of the couch. And
I was like a minute over here.
Yeah. And then, yeah.
Anyway.
Okay.
You're killing, man. Why?
Yeah, you are killing.
You came through the qualifiers, didn't you?
I got really lucky with the fucking brawls. Dude, that was just unbelievable. Both of them were like 20%, I think. Mm-hmm. And I won both. If I didn't win the Antonidas brawl, I would have won that game for sure.
Mike,
freeze beat Warrior, like, world first. And
yeah, that was crazy, yeah.
And now I got a pretty good mirror match. I knew I had the advantage because he runs two blocks, and so he overdraws, maybe. Mm-hmm. He only runs one Shredder, and I run two, so there's a slight advantage.
Okay.
We thought the Geddon, too. The Geddon is like the bonus legendary.
Yeah, that as well. Yeah. But I don't run Thorsen instead, for example.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I guess we... Okay.
Yeah, that card sucks.
he couldn't beat that wing.
It's overrated. Yeah.
It's a tough wing. It's a tough wing, but it's fine. Well,
wins the Freeze Mage game, but not many other games. I don't know.
Okay. Well, it wins just enough. Yeah.
First in group, pretty happy about that. So
first in group.
It's more of a top 16.
Yeah, you're actually the first person to qualify, I believe, for the round of 16.
Yeah, the winners of Group F are Faramir and Sho. But their winners' match is still about to
All right.
Yeah.
That's about interesting to as well.
So you'll be facing one of them, the loser. Actually, no.
No, I don't think it's done like that.
Right, because someone else can come from loser's bracket. Because he'll be facing the loser of that, right?
I don't know if it's actually seeded like that. They might just do a draw.
I heard it's randomized seeds. Like they did the last time. I'm not sure.
Okay. Yeah, that would make sense.
Man, I've been watching too much football. I mean soccer.
But it should be announced today, right?
I mean
by
football.
The end of today,
we're in
so
Germany.
Study up. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Stuff.
All right.
Stuff.
All right.
Yeah.
Who do you think's going to get second place in your group?
Because
that's three pretty sacked players.
I was really scared of facing Garen in case he beat Amaz because of his lineup.
Yeah.
Gladly, I didn't face him, but... I think Gaara has a lot of potential, but I think Gaara might beat Taj, and then there's the rematch versus Amaz.
There's one thing I really wanted to know. I was actually surprised to hear that you were not a seed. You were qualified through this tournament.
Yeah,
What was that like?
I got a second chance. There was two phases to qualify. It was a best of one Swiss. I got 7-2 and got into top 32, which split into 16-man groups. Of each 16-man group, we play best of three single elimination, where the top two qualify. I got into the semis. I lost. The Korean guy that qualified ended up not coming because it's kind of expensive for them. So I had a second chance against the other semi-finalist, and I beat him 2-1 for the spot.
Damn. Wow. You are like not even supposed to be here, and you're just crushing through everybody. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Hope it continues tomorrow and the day after. So.
I mean, you know, there's a lot of these tournaments, but... The little guy in me always wants the guy who qualified to win.
Yeah.
Thanks, Crip.
Yeah, that's what the internet wants as well, I think. Any other questions, you guys?
Are you scared, Saviz? Are you scared?
Ignite
I'm
is
a little
coming
bit scared.
For you.
I mean, Ignite was doing so well, but I finished first in my group too, so we shouldn't be playing
even, then.
First thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
But really impressive, and congrats.
Thanks.
All right, cool. Well, congratulations once again. We're going to go ahead and jump to a quick commercial break, guys. Right. And when we come back, we'll be having that loser match between Gaara and Thais.
Loser match?
I thought I'd say that, but
that's
loser match.
Probably the most epic loser match of the tournament so far.
All right.
Maybe just of the tournament.
It could be.
Yeah.
Especially in the round of 32. It's like, really? But really. So we'll be right back, guys.